nothing really says Chicago like encased meat, also known as the Red Hot. Hot dog to the ordinary person, but here in Chicago, perhaps no place is more famous here on the border of Chicago in the suburbs than Gene and Jude. They've been around for over 60 years, so they're doing something right. I love hot dogs.
At Gene and Jude's, you can't order just one hot dog. It's impossible.
We need 11 dogs, two plain.
The demand for the Red Hots at Gene and Jude's is unbelievably high. And if you look at the menu, it's easy to see why. It's really all they have. See?
Why is this one of the best in Chicago?
Everything we do here is like, we keep it simple. There's just one thing we have on the menu is hot dogs. So when you have only one thing, you can specialize.
Wait a minute, I'm gonna correct you, bro. You have tamales too.
Yeah, we have tamales.
You're fired.
The tamales are good, but nothing trumps these dogs. You'll notice something else here. Gene and Jude's tops all their dogs with a mound of fresh cut spuds, something Gene invented nearly 70 years ago.
He was at a ball game back in the 40s. Yeah. And he was ordering hot dogs, and he was trying to figure out, how can I make something unique? And then he started experimenting with putting fries in the dog. And
holy cow!
Since then, there's been many places that have copied, but you know, we're the all one and only.
That's right, French fries on top of the dog. We love it. It all ends up in the same place, right? I mean, a little fry grease dripping down the dog makes for a classic Chicago experience.
Come here, you little wiener. Come here.
But don't expect the classic Chicago-style dog. We're ditching the celery, salt, pickle, and tomato wedge.
What makes this a classic, and why is it different?
You know, when Gene started out, he uses the ingredients we do, the mustard, the sweet relish, onions, and the peppers, because those complement the hot dog and gives it the best taste.
Careful, man. Don't bite your fingers off, man. Ravenous, like a Wolverine. Talk to me about ketchup. How do you feel about it?
Ketchup's a bad word over here. There's a Clint Eastwood movie, one of the Dirty Harry movies. One of the other cops was having a hot dog, and he got like really upset. He's like,
nobody, I mean nobody, puts ketchup on a hot dog.
So if you want ketchup, you're gonna have to go rooting underneath the seats of your car.
Ketchup, come on, just a little bit of ketchup. Ketchup for the fries, I mean, oh, it's leaking. This guy's been coming here since 1964.
Yeah, getting four hot dogs.
Dude, I wasn't even born yet.
No.
How many hot dogs have you eaten from this place?
Then I couldn't tell you.
Come on, take a guess.
Once a week, I don't know.
Once a week, yeah. Times four since 1964.
Whatever that comes out.
That's like 6,438. I got a C+ in math. Hot dog! Hot dog! Hey, bro. I can't finish this. It's a classic. So you like hot dogs?
I love hot dogs. Yeah. They're my passion.
He's a bit narcissistic, as far as wieners go.
And I don't get to this side of town that often, but when I do, I have to stop here.
You get two
it's
dogs.
It's a process. Oh, you gotta have two.
You can never get just one.
Oh, no.
I mean, they make fun of you if you just get one dog.
Right, that's like flying with one wing.
Right. You can't do it. You're just in a circle
exactly.
The whole time, right?
Right.
But you're flying straight, baby.
There you go.
All right.
Hey, I'm flying straight here, people.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is Captain speaking. Fasten your seatbelts. We're coming in for a landing.
So what do you think? Gene and Jude's? Classic Chicago? Not classic Chicago? I say it is. We say it is. Do you agree? Disagree? Log on to chicagosbesttv.com. Give us your opinion. I'm talking to you.